Now, let us study about excitation and ionization of an atom. If we just talk about excitation, you might have studied about atomic excitation in chemistry also. And here excitation we can simply define as transition of an electron in atom from ground state. Ground state is basically used to term for lowest energy level in any atom. This for n equals to 1, that is the lowest energy state. It can be written as lowest energy level also. So, excitation is termed as transition of an electron in an atom from ground state to higher state by absorption of energy by this electron. When the electron absorbs some energy and it makes a transition from ground state to the higher state or any lower energy level to the higher energy level, this phenomena we call excitation, and this higher state to which the electron is transiting is termed as excited state of the electron. In case of hydrogenic atom, always the only electron available in the atom will remain in n equals to 1 or ground state. But if it is not hydrogenic, then the electron in any outer level may excite to any higher level. That phenomena will also be considered as excitation. If we talk about ionization, then for ionization of hydrogenic atom or any other atom, we can define as it is the transition of electron from any level to n tending to infinity. That is basically zero energy state. We have already studied zero energy level where electron energy is zero. Or here we can write that is removal of electron from the atom, because if an electron reaches infinite energy level, that means its total energy is zero and it is free from the attraction of nucleus. So, removal of electron from that atom by absorption of energy by electron. So, when externally energy is supplied to an electron and this energy is sufficient enough to remove the electron from the atom, then this phenomena is called ionization. And excitation is just transition of electron from any lower level or in hydrogenic atom from ground state or n equals to 1 to any higher energy level. Here we can also state that for excitation and ionization of an atom, energy can be supplied to an atom in two ways. These are the two ways we are going to discuss one by one in detail. The very first method is by electromagnetic radiation photon, by supplying electromagnetic radiation or light photons onto an atom, the energy can be supplied. And the other is by collisions with other particles. When different particles collide to an atom, these may supply some energy during collision while the transfer of momentum takes place. And if that energy is sufficient enough for excitation or ionization, both of these phenomena may take place. First, we'll start with electromagnetic radiation photon supply of energy, and later we'll discuss about collision phenomena also.